Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC693PWR330 high capacity power supply. This is a high capacity power supply for the 9030 series system. And the test is just going to be basically to show you guys if you have a good working unit or not. To give a quick description of what I have in front of you is an IC693CHS397 5-slot base, 5-slot chassis. You guys can use the 391, the larger 391 if you want. The most important thing is to make sure that you have a CPU in it, because that's going to be required for the test to test the port. Okay. So as you can see, I've already got it powered up. I'm going to shut it down for you guys just so you can see what it is that I'm seeing. When you turn it on, the first thing that you should get is a green power LED to indicate that the power supply is actually supplying power. And then, of course, an OK light or lights on your CPU to show that it's giving power to the backplane. All right. For that matter, if you wanted to, you could also fill the rack with other devices that have lights on them so you can see that the power supply is giving power if you don't have a CPU that has lights. All right. So the next thing I'm going to show you is the basic wiring that I have going on here. I'm going to open up this door. I have my hot lead going to the top screw, my neutral lead going to the second screw down, and I would normally have a ground, not for this test, but I would have a ground on the third screw. And the bottom two screws, the top of the two, is for the positive lead to the 24-volt DC output that this power supply has, and then the bottom most screw is the negative lead for the 24-volt DC output, and that's good for 8/10 of an amp. Okay. Now, a couple of the things that you guys should know about this before we test the port. Of course, there's a IC693ACC301 battery. Here's an example of the battery. All right, very common size battery with a plug on it. And in the event that the LED is on and it's red next to where it says battery, would be telling you that the battery is no longer good, is either dead or disconnected, it needs checking or replacing, underneath of this door right here. So I have a plastic tool that I'm going to use to open that door. You guys could possibly use a small flathead screwdriver if you're very careful, but I would just stress that whatever you do, be very careful not to damage the case. And this door comes right off. And underneath, it's a battery that's actually clipped into the door itself, and then the wire goes to the plug receptacle. All right? And if you guys can see that, it's at the tip of my pointer here. All right, but anyway, that's in good shape, so I'm going to put that back. And the next thing, of course, is I'm going to test my programming port, okay? Now, as you can see on the power supply, this says PS port, power supply port. And what it's telling me is that when I go to hook up to the CPU374, it should start blinking to show communication through this path. So I've got my programming cable with a 15-pin. And I'm going to put that on there. And associate it the proper way would be better. Okay. And the next thing I'm going to do is we're going to need the software for this. We're going to go into Prophecy Machine Edition. I have an open file here for CPU374, and it's set up so that I can use this particular port. And I'm going to go ahead and hit the lightning bolt icon. All I want to do is to make sure I'm able to connect through this port, and I am. Okay. So a couple things. I'm now connected, as the Prophecy Machine Edition is indicating. If you guys follow my arrow here, you can see I have a green handprint, and it says connected to device under my feedback zone. Okay, so you should see those things. And also, you should physically see the power supply light blinking. At the tip of my finger here is the LED telling me that this is actually communicating and talking right now. All right. So that would tell me I have a good working power supply. What you would look for in a power supply that's not working is quite obviously a power supply where you don't get any lights on at all. Or if you power it up, and I do recommend you power it in a room that's fairly quiet, if you hear the power supply screeching, making a kind of a screeching noise, the only way I can describe it, that's a power supply that I would recommend replacing and or repair, but most likely replacing. Okay, that would indicate that something's wrong with it. And of course, if this port isn't working, we wouldn't be able to connect, we wouldn't be able to be talking to the power supply port, and it would indicate to us in Prophecy Machine Edition that it was unable to connect. And then that would mean that you have a port failure on your programming port, okay? So any of those things that could possibly be wrong. IC693PWR330 high capacity power supply is something that we very commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We have exchange programs and new and remanufactured products. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.